when the comments made by Silvio Berlusconi's wife accusing him of consorting with minors were making the headlines, we talked to an academic and Byzantine historian who set the sexual scandal of the day in a historical context, which she claimed rendered it all peculiarly Italian. Today, we thought it might be interesting to hear from her again.
Good afternoon, this is Silvia Ronche, your Byzantine historian from Rome, with the most recent news about the Byzantine bagarre on the Italian Prime Minister. On the columns of our newspapers today, as actually every day, are towering pictures of heavily made-up, long-haired young ladies making their statements about issues that in Italy are nowadays regarded as political. What the Prime Minister's villa's restrooms look like, whether and how much and by whom they have been paid to, quote, escort an aged gentleman presently leading our government. On the same columns, philological inquiries are made about the actual meaning of the substantive escort, which is increasingly used in our political debate by those who wish to avoid the expression high-class prostitute, mentioned by the director of a scandal-mongering magazine named Key, a tabloid that seems to have acquired an even larger political influence than our traditional press. You know, we are ancient. We have had Nero and Agrippina and Poppaea and Tacitus and Suetonius, and we've had the popes as political leaders for centuries, men of power who went across the most serious sexual scandals. And we've had Dante Alighieri, who wrote a whole poem on the vices of the politicians of his own time. We are disillusioned, and we are Catholic, which means much more tolerant than you about moral compromises in the private sphere. We're not easily scandalized or outraged by the private vices of our politicians. What we care about are the public, properly political actions. So the Italians are very irritated today when they read the newspapers or turn on their TVs, especially the broadcasts of our state TV. They are angry at the right wing that, in order to justify Berlusconi, is lowering the moral standards and is managing to depict as normal a vulgar, private and namely sexual behavior. The sexual behaviors that are presented as normal by the right-winged medias, including TVs, are certainly alien to the larger part of the Italians. But they are private, and the Italians are equally angry at the left wing that has chosen the sexual gossip to put down Berlusconi and that is mixing up the private and the public issues. All this apparent stuff, which is filling up the Italian medias, is the result of our left wing's strategy. And I'm not sure that the Italians would easily forgive the left-wing political class for this vulgar use of the gossip in the political game. You know, we are ancient and disillusioned, but we are also the inventors of the res publica and of the sense of the state.
The personal views there of Italian historian Silvia Ronche.